बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ ग्रेड टेंथ। इट्स माय फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 8। इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द रीडिंग अलोंग विद द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ द होल यूनिट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द बुक एक्सरसाइजेस। सो ओपन योर बुक्स एट पेज नंबर 78। पेज नंबर इज 78। The first one exercise is of glossary in which some words along with their meanings are given. Dear students, I think there is no need of explaining the words and their meanings to you, as we have already discussed them in detail while we were doing the reading. But let me tell you once again that in your paper in section A in MCQs, these vocabulary words are included along with the four options, in which only one will be correct and you will have to encircle the correct one. So keep in mind the meanings of all these words. Now come to exercise number 2, which is of comprehension. Answer the following questions. How did Qaed Azam empower and emancipate the Muslim women of subcontinent? Question number 2. How did Begum Fatima, the principal of Jinnah Islamia College, mobilize female students? Number 3. Why did the Qaed Azam stress the importance of women as equal partners of men in the creation of separate homeland for Muslims? Now turn the page. Describe the role of Muslim women in Pakistan movement, highlighting their love and aspiration for their new homeland. Number 5. Analyze the third paragraph of the lesson, Women's Role in the Pakistan Movement, and identify the sentences that support the main idea through cause and effect. Number 6. What ideas and issues have been explored in the fifth paragraph of the text, Women's Role in Pakistan Movement? Dear students, the answers of all these questions are written. We have written it and submitted it in the office. You can come and collect them in hard copy. Now the next exercise is choose the correct option. These kinds of statements along the sentences with their options are always given in the paper in MCQs. Most of the Muslim women led seculated lives within their homes. By using contextual clue, the word closest in meaning to seculated is number 1, option number A, involve little in outside social activities. Number B, involve too much in activities outside their homes. Number C, banned to take part in social activities. D, prohibited the law to take part in social activities. So option A, involved little in outside social activities, is the correct option. Number 2. By the mid 40s, a galaxy of women had emerged in the leadership role of Muslim League. In this sentence, the word galaxy means a group of impressive persons, a system of numerous stars, a cluster of brightly heavenly bodies, community of people. So option A, a group of impressive persons, is the correct one. Number 3. It was Qaed Azam who brought about social revolution in the emancipation and empowerment of women. In this sentence, the word social revolution means option A, communal revolt, option B, societal change, number C, social disorder, and number D, economical changes. So societal change is the correct one option. after reading the lesson. Women's role in Pakistan movement. It is inferred that the role of women expanded because of Daesh. Number A, B. Amma speeches to Caliphate gathering, Fatma Jinnah participation in all activities of Qaid-e-Azam who stressed the importance of women as equal partners of men in struggle for separate homeland. Option 4, Begum Fatima who invited Qaid-e-Azam to address the girl students of her college. So option C, Qaid-e-Azam who stressed the importance of women as equal partners of men in the struggle for a separate homeland is the correct one option. After reading the lesson, Women's Role in Pakistan Movement, it can be concluded that the paragraphs are arranged in chronological order, journal to specific, specific to journal, and spatial order. So the option A, chronological order, is the correct one option. Now come to page number 81, a grammar exercise. Rewrite the complete sentences using the adverb in the bracket in the usual position. I must see a dentist. So where can we put also? We can put it, I must also see a doctor. I must also see a doctor. I was joking. I was joking. I was only joking. I was only joking. Or I was only joking. We can also write that I was joking only. Did you enjoy the film? Did you both enjoy the film? Did you both enjoy the film? Javeria watches TV hardly. Javeria watches TV hardly. Javeria hardly watches TV. Javeria hardly watches TV. Number 5. She drives her car. She drives her car carefully. She drives her car carefully. Now come to page number 82, exercise number C. Exercise number C is of complete the sentences using an adjective and adverb. Dear students, you know it very well that what is adjective and what is adverb. Adjective modifies noun and adverb modifies verb. He is always in a rush. I don't understand why he walks so hurry or hurriedly. The correct option is hurriedly. Number 2nd is, I prefer studying in the library. It's always dash. It's always quiet. It's always quiet. Number 3. Masood dash took the assistant job. He had been looking for a position all summer. Masood happily took. Happily took. Number 4. They speak Pashto very dash. They lived in Peshawar for 2 years. They speak Pashto very well. Please be dash in the hallway. The walls have just been painted. Please be careful. Please be careful. Now come to exercise D. Fill in the blanks with the correct comparative superlative form of the adverbs. Number 1, we walked then the rest of the people slowly. We walked as there then is used, so we will use the comparative degree. There is comparison, so we will use the comparative degree. We walked slower. We walked slower. We walked slower. We walked slower than them.
नंबर वन, वी वॉकड डैश देन रेस्ट ऑफ द पीपल. वी वॉकड मोर स्लोली. वी वॉकड मोर स्लोली. वी वॉकड मोर स्लोली. मोर स्लोली. द मैन ड्रोव देन लास्ट टाइम. फॉर सुपरलेटिव डिग्री विल बी यूज्ड एज देन इज यूज्ड. सो द मैन ड्रोव फॉर्थर. द मैन ड्रोव फॉर्थर देन लास्ट टाइम. नंबर थ्री, दे कॉल्ड अस डैश इन द आफ्टरनून. दे कॉल अस लेटर इन द आफ्टरनून. नंबर फोर, द वर्क वेंट डैश टूडे बिकॉज ऑफ द वर्कर्स शोड अप. द वर्क वेंट वेल. माय मदर एंड माय सिस्टर टॉक देन द अदर गेस्ट्स मोर लाउडली. माय मदर एंड माय सिस्टर टॉक्ड मोर लाउडली देन द अदर गेस्ट्स. नाउ कम टू पेज नंबर 83, इन विच देयर इज एन एक्सरसाइज. Underline the adverb phrases in the following sentences. Underline the adverb phrase in the following sentences. So let me tell you what is an adverb phrase. An adverb phrase is a prepositional phrase that modifies a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. It is called adverb phrase by pointing out when, where, why, how, and to what extent. An adverb phrase may come before or after the modified word. So now come to the exercise. We will underline the adverb phrase in the sentences. We hurried down the street to catch the bus. Why we come hurried down? We have to answer why. To catch the bus. So, to catch the bus is the adverb phrase. She was born on the same, on the very same day as her friend. So, when? On the very same day. On the very same day is adverb phrase. Number three, Asad fell asleep holding his book. Who fell asleep and how? Holding his book. Number four, every now and then they met and chat. Every now and then. We have the adverb phrases every now and then. For now, I would like to ask you to leave. Adverb phrase is for now. For now, underline for now. Now come to page number 84. The last exercise, F is of underline the adverb clause in the following sentences. Let me explain you what is an adverb clause. An adverb clause is a group of words that is used to change or qualify the meaning of an adjective, a verb, another adverb, or any other type of word or phrase with the exception of determiner and adjectives that directly modifies nouns. Now come to the exercise. We have to underline the adverb clause. Whether you like it or not, you have to go to bed now. The adverb clause in this sentence is whether you like it or not. Unless you run fast, you will miss the bus. Unless you run fast is the adverb clause. Once they saw the car coming, the bird flew away from the street. And once they saw the car coming is the adverb clause. Number four, although she has a business degree, she is working as a clerk. Although she has a business degree. Number five, you must keep practicing the math question until you get it right. Until you get it right. Number six, give us a call when you get back from your trip. When you get back from your trip is adverb clause. Number 7. Since I will be working late, I will eat dinner at the office. Adverb clause is since I will be working late. The fireworks shows will start after the sun goes down. Adverb clause is after the sun goes down. Number 9. Whenever you promise to do something, you need to keep it. Adverb clause is whenever you promise to do something. This one is the adverb clause.
Dear students of grade 10th, with this we have completed our unit number 8 and all the course of our midterm. So do the practice of all the book exercises and do the translation of all the units and do the learning of all the notes which we have given to you in hard copy. So in your midterm exam or in your test, it will help you a lot. Thank you, students.